wine girl. I'm Italian and you can tell from my huge accent, and I'm the wine girl because I'm a professional sommelier, a wine journalist and a wine educator. So I'm here today to talk to you about sparkling wines, but before going into that, I would love to explain you why I decided to open this YouTube channel. So it's an experiment for me. I never did like YouTube videos before, so please help me, give me advice and comment below what in your opinion can be improved and what you would love to see on this channel. But my idea is to give you instrument to better understand what's behind wine production and to better understand how to make smart choices in terms of wine. What I mean, when you go to the supermarket, you see a lot of wines on the shelves, you go online, you wanna buy a wine, but you really can't understand the labels, why this wine does cost so much, why this wine is so cheap. So you would like to be, you know, guided among this huge offer of wines you have out there. And I'm here to help you. So that's why I decided to open this YouTube channel. So if you like it, please subscribe and give me a thumbs up because I need your support. And give me your comments so I will improve my next videos. So now let's get into the 10 things you absolutely need to know about sparkling wines. Point number one, sparkling wines are not soda. So I just carbonated my water, and as you can see, now I have bubbles in there, but it's not the way in which sparkling wine are produced. So basically, to obtain bubbles in a wine, they inject yeast and sugar to start a second fermentation. And they do that in a sealed container, because the byproduct of the fermentation is CO2, and I want to keep the CO2 in the wine to have the bubbles. So there are two methods of production, the Chorma method or Martinotti method, and the Champenoise method or Metodo Tradizionale. In the first case, the second fermentation takes place in big stainless steel tank. In the second case, the second fermentation takes place in the bubble. I don't want to get into this because maybe I will record another video about this, the differences between these two methods, but what you need to know is that the bubbles are natural and are not injected in the sparkling wines. So please look for wine produced with these two methods, Chorma method or Champenoise method. In some wine region, not in Europe, they allow winemakers to add CO2 to obtain a sparkling wine. That are not the kind of sparkling wine you want to drink. Number two, champagne is not synonym of sparkling wine. So stop, please, referring to every single sparkling wine as champagne or champagne, as you pronounce it here in the United States. So champagne actually is a wine region in France. So here you see this. So it's the proper name of the wine region. It's like saying Napa, Sonoma, Australia. So it's a place, and the wine takes the name of the place, but it's not synonym of sparkling wine. So when you go to have your brunch on Sunday morning and they offer you, do you like a glass of champagne? And you say yes, and they bring you a Prosecco. So please tell the waiter, you told me it was champagne. Point number three is related to point number two. So champagne is not a synonym of sparkling wine, and champagne is not a grape. So I saw in supermarket somebody selling champagne grape, and here's a picture, but it doesn't exist. I mean, champagne is made of three different kinds of grapes, that is Chardonnay, Pinot Noir and Pinot Meunier, and there's no champagne grape. So Prosecco is not champagne and is not synonym of sparkling wine. So as you see, Prosecco here is the name of this Italian sparkling wine, but it's not champagne. It's made with a different different method, the Sharmat method, and not metodo tradizionale. We will get into that in another video, but as you can see, it's the name of the wine. This wine from Italy is called Prosecco, but not every single sparkling wine is called Prosecco. So as you see here, we have champagne, and this is Prosecco, and so we have different kinds. It's like when you want to call a beer Corona, for saying beer, you use the word Corona. You know, that's a brand, that's the name of beer, it's not a synonym of beer. Another thing you have to keep in mind, it is the service temperature. So sparkling wine needs to be served chilled, like at 50-54 Fahrenheit or 10-12 Celsius. And to keep it chilled during your, you know, consumption, you need for sure a ice bucket. And when you ask for it in the restaurant, usually they bring you the ice bucket like full of ice, like this. But what they don't know is that just ice won't chill the wine, won't keep it chilled. You need to add water, because the ice melting with some water will release the cold that needs to keep the bubble chilled. This is the right way to chill wine, not just with ice and water. If you want to speed up the process, you can add salt. One thing you need to choose carefully for sparkling wine is the glass. Usually they serve you sparkling wine in the flute. I don't even have flute in my house, so I will put a picture of a flute here. It's the narrow, long glass, but it's not the ideal one for sparkling wine, because it's so narrow you can't stick your nose in there, so you can smell the wine, and it's just very little, long and narrow, so it's not the ideal glass. The ideal and proper glass for a sparkling wine is this shape. This is actually a Franciacorta glass. So the name of the glass is like the name of this Italian wine, this Italian sparkling wine produced with a traditional method. And they like copyrighted the shape of this glass because it is the ideal one to taste sparkling wine. If you don't have any like this, like a white wine glass is even better than a flute. How to pour properly sparkling wine? So you just need to bend a little bit the glass and to pour it carefully, because you don't want to waste the bubbles. So just point it at the, you know, surface of the glass and pour it carefully. So you will see that it won't create a big foam and the bubbles won't be wasted. So as I was telling you, this is the ideal glass for sparkling, because you see how the bubbles like form a spiral in the middle, and you can stick your nose in there, smelling all the aromas and enjoying the beautiful view of the chain of pearls of bubbles creating in the glass. Now that you have your sparkling wine in the proper glass, you want to enjoy it. Which is the best way? So first you smell it, and then you take a little sip. You feel the perlage, like the prix de mousse, how the French call it, in your mouth, so you wanna feel the bubbles. What people sometimes do just to look fancy and to look like, oh, I know about wines, is to swirl the glass. This is the worst thing you can do with sparkling wine, because you're gonna waste all the bubbles, so you're gonna like dissolve the bubbles, and when you're gonna drink it, it's gonna be like a still white wine. So you don't wanna swirl your glass with sparkling wine in it. Sometimes it happens you don't finish the whole bottle of sparkling wine, and maybe you wanna keep it for the next day or the next evening with your friends, with your wife, whatever. So if you want to preserve the bubbles of the sparkling wine, I suggest you to buy one of these. This is a stopper that is made properly for the sparkling wine bottles. So you just pop it in there and you just close it tightly. So it will preserve the bubbles and it will allow the wine to last, let's say, a couple of days in your fridge, not more. And once the bubbles are gone, the sparkling wine is no more good to be drunk. something you want to understand about the labels of sparkling wine is this little, you know, written here. There is extra dry, sometimes there is brut, sometimes there is extra brut. This is the dosage. What's the dosage? It's the additional sugar and wine they add before bottling the wine to balance the acidity. So depending on the quantity of sugar and wine they're adding to the bottle, there are different levels of, you know, dry, extra dry, brut, extra brut. So I will put down in the info box the classification, and if you understand this, you will know before buying the wine if it's more dry or more on the sweet side. And it's very important to know before choosing the right sparkling wine. So this is all for today's videos, guys. I hope you enjoyed the 10 things you need to know about sparkling wines. I will soon record another video about the differences between Charmat method and Metodo Tradizionale, and I will go through different kind of sparkling wine you can find on the market. For now, cheers, and please subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up for this video.